Hello and welcome to Augusto Blender channel. This is my first Blender tutorial. In this tutorial, I will show you how to create a polygonal tileable pattern of a Foan lab. From this pattern, you can create tileable displacement, normal or bump maps. Or you can watch the next tutorial and learn how to use this polygonal pattern to create complex meshes. First, let's configure the scene. Delete all the objects and add a monkey. In the top view, go to the orthographic view and press Alt G, Alt R and Alt S to clear the monkey's rotation, scale and location. Add an array modifier. Enable merge and set the count to 3. In the edit mode, if you scale the monkey, you can see that the copies maintain their respective position. This is because the relative offset is on. So, enable the constant offset and disable the relative offset. Set the x value of the constant offset to 1. Now, if you scale the monkey in edit mode, you can see that the copies maintain their global position. Now copy the array modifier and set the x value to negative 1. Copy again and set the x value to 0 and the y value to 1. Copy one last time and set the y value to negative 1. Add a camera, press Alt R, Alt G and Alt S and put the camera above your objects. In the camera parameters, set the lens parameter of the camera to orthographic and the orthographic scale to 1. Since we are creating square texture tiles, your texture resolution needs to be square. Set to 1024 by 1024. Now you can go to edit mode, rotate the monkey. You can see that you have a tileable. You can see now that you have a tileable render. Now we will model the Foan pattern. Hide the camera so she don't get in your way. Select the monkey, go to edit mode and merge all the vertex. Select merge at cursor. In the top view, extrude the only vertex of your mesh and move it up and right a little. Now add a skin modifier and a subsurface modifier. You can change the scale of the skin modifier by pressing Ctrl A. You can restrict your scale by pressing X or Y. Now move the vertex until you have the edge in the required angle. Then duplicate this edge and move the vertex until they merge together. You can see now that you have long stripes. Now duplicate those edges and rotate them. Select one of these edges and move until the vertex merge together again. You can toggle the visibility of the skin modifier on and off to easily see what you are modeling, and the wireframe is better for this task. Now move to perpendicular edges in the Z-axis. Select all edges and subdivide to have more geometry to work with. Select some edges and move it a little so the Foan edge is more natural. And that's it. Now you have your Foan edge. You can do any kinds of pattern. Since this tutorial is not a render tutorial, you can play with your material and render settings until you are satisfied.